वेलकम बैक टू क्लास 8 मैथमेटिक्स। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू चैप्टर नंबर 10 पार्ट 2 इनवर्स वेरिएशन विद फ्यू एग्जांपल्स ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 10th बी। डियर फ्रेंड्स, इन द लास्ट पीरियड वी हैव लर्नड अबाउट direct variation. Today we are going to learn inverse variation. The name itself suggests inverse means opposite. If one quantity increases, the other quantity decreases, or if one quantity decreases, the other quantity increases. Like if to complete any piece of work, if suppose number of men increases, the time required for completing it work decreases. And opposite to it, if number of men decreases, then the time required increases. So, the inverse variation, we can say two quantities X and Y are said to be in inverse variation. If increase in X, that is one quantity, causes corresponding decrease in Y, that is another quantity, and decrease in X causes a corresponding increase in Y. So in this case, we can say the two quantities are in inverse variation. In other words, we can explain the same concept as the quantities are inversely proportional if an increase in one quantity corresponds to a constant decrease in the other quantity, or if decrease in a one quantity corresponds to a constant increase in the other quantity. In this type of variation, you can say that X and Y, which are in inverse variation or in inverse proportion, the product of X and Y is constant. It means XY is a constant. And if you will take a set of quantities as X1, X2, X3 with the different values of X and corresponding quantities of y1, y2, y3, then x1 multiplied by y1 is equal to x2 multiplied by y2 is equal to x3 multiplied by y3 is equal to x4 multiplied by y4, and so on. And these all products are always constant. Let us check with few examples. So, dear friends, here Zahida can go her school in 4 different ways. She can walk, run, or she can go by riding bicycle, or she can go by car. Now, here a very obvious it is. When she will walk, then the time required for reaching school will be more. When she will run, the time required will be less. And when she will go by riding bicycle, the time will be further less. And if she will go by car, the time will be least. You can observe here in this chart. Here, dear friends, in this chart, we have taken speed in kilometer per hour as a quantity X, while time taken in the minutes as a quantity Y. And you can observe here when she goes by walking, running, cycling, or by car, here her speed is increasing. while the time taken by her to reach school is constantly decreasing. As the mean of transport is changing. So we can say that as the speed is increasing, the corresponding other quantity, that is time, is decreasing. And if you will further notice over here, the product of x and y in the first case, that is 3 into 30, or product of x2 and y2 in the second case, 6 into 15, or in the third case, product of x3 and y3, 9 into 10, or product of last quantity, that is 45 into 2. In each case, this product is constant, and that is 90 over here. So from this example, we can say that here this is the inverse proportion concept. Let us see few more examples. A school wants to spend rupees 6000 on mathematics book. How many books can be bought for rupees 40 each? So here, look at this example. The school wants to purchase few books of mathematics so that students can make use of it for practicing more. And school wants to spend rupees 6000 in order to purchase mathematics books. So from this we can clearly observe that each book is costing 6000 divided by 40, that is 150 rupees. Means price of one book is 150 rupees. But if suppose here the price, or we can say quantity X, we will increase more than 40, then whether the number of books will be remaining 150 or the number will change? Let us observe this chart. Here we will take the two quantities as X and Y. Price we will consider as X and number of books we will consider as Y. Now here, when each notebook cost 40 rupees, then number of books purchased by school will be 150 rupees. If suppose we will increase the price of book 50 rupees, then the number of books will get reduced as 120 rupees. Further, on increasing the price of book, the number of books will reduce. Here it is 60 as a price and number of books in that case is 100. If further you will increase price of each book 75 rupees, then the number of books will reduce as 80 rupees. Further on increasing price as 80 rupees, the number of books will be 75 rupees. If suppose again you will increase price of book 100 rupees, then the number of books here this time will be 60 only. And if you will note over here, then the product of each pair of quantity, that is x1 into y1 is equal to x2 into y2 is equal to x3 into y3 is equal to x4 into y4 is equal to x5 into y5 is equal to x6 into y6. That is 40 into 150 is equal to 50 into 120 is equal to 60 into 100. Is equal to 75 into 80, is equal to 80 into 75 in the next case, is equal to 100 into 60. And each time the product XY will be 6000. Let us check the same concept with one more example. Here, look at this example. Whether in the following tables, x and y vary inversely or not. So here in the table, they have given the values of x and y. Look at the values and just observe these values are in inverse proportion or not. So if you will take here value of x as a 2, then quantity y is 32. Now, in the second case, value of x is 4, then the y is 16. Third time, value of x is 8, then value of y decreases further as 8. Now, if you will notice, each of the time, here, value of x is increasing. Here, value of x is increasing. While simultaneously, the value of y each time is decreasing. Isn't it? Now let us observe whether their product is constant or not. So, if it is inverse variation, then first condition, that is increase in one quantity, makes the decrease in corresponding other quantity, which is here applied. Let us go for the second thing, that is product of x and y is remaining constant or not. So here, look at this product number 1, x1 multiplied by y1, that is 2 multiplied by 32, and it is 64. While that of the second product, x2 into y2, that is 4 into 16, is 64 once again. Third case, x3 into y3 is equal to 8 into 8. Also here it is 64. Means in all these three cases, you can notice the product of both the quantities, that is x1 into y1, x2 into y2 and x3 into y3 is constant. And since we can say that these both quantities x and y vary in inverse proportion. Or we can say this is an example of inverse variation. If 78 men can do a work in 140 days, in how many days will 42 men do the same work? Here, let 42 men will do same work in the D days. And we will write all the quantities in the chart. Number of men as X and number of days as Y. 78 men can do the work in 140 days and 42 men can do the same work in D days. Since one quantity increases, the other decreases, it is a case of inverse variation. And hence, the product of X and Y will remain constant. That is 78 multiplied by 140 equal to 42 multiplied by D. By X1 into Y1 equal to X2 into Y2. Since it is the inverse variation. Here, we need to calculate value of D. Since we need to calculate here value of D, 42 we will transpose. So 78 multiplied by 140 divided by 42. On doing the number crunch, you will get the answer 260. So hence we can say 42 men will do the same piece of work in 260 days. With this example, we will try to learn inverse variation. The name itself suggests inverse variation means when a quantity increases, then corresponding another quantity decreases. And if one quantity decreases, then another corresponding quantity increases. The same you can notice here, if speed of car increases, then the time taken to reach is decreased. So here, time taken to travel from Mumbai to Pune, as the speed of car increases, time is decreased. Let us see what is happening here. Oh, it's inter-school dance competition. And winning team is going to get a cash prize of 10,000. Now, it is a group dance competition. If the number of candidates in the group will increase, then the money distributed will decrease. Here all are guessing that their team will win. Let us discuss inverse variation with this example. If number of students in a group is X increases, then amount of money distributed in members will decrease. Here, when the two group members are there, then amount each will get out of 10,000 as 5,000. If four groups members are there, then each member will get 2,500 out of 10,000 rupees. If group members are five, then each member will get 2,000 rupees out of 10,000 rupees. We can use the concept of inverse variation, that product of quantities is constant. So here X and Y are two quantities and their product is constant. If it is non-zero number, then the both quantities are said to be in inverse variation. So here, this relationship we can denote as X is inversely proportional to Y. And X into Y is always constant. Here product of X1 and Y1 is equal to product of X2 and Y2 is equal to product of X3 and Y3. Or we can say in another word, X1 upon X2 is equal to Y2 upon Y1. On multiplying in the cross way, we will get the same equation. So here, if there are 8 members in group, then how much rupees each member will get out of 10,000 rupees? Let us calculate by using the concept of inverse variation. Here, number of students X and amount of rupee Y. So X1 into Y1 is equal to X2 into Y2 and it is constant, that is 10,000. So you can see here X2 as 8, then we have to calculate Y2. If consider X1 is 2 and Y1 is 5,000, then X1 into Y1 equal to X2 into Y2. On substituting their values, we can calculate value of Y2 and here it is rupees 1250. So each candidate of group containing 8 members will get 1250 rupees from 10,000 prize. I hope you understood by this animation. Let us take one example from our text. A farmer has enough cattle feed to feed 16 cows for 4 days. How long it feed last if he had the feed of 32 cows? So here we will write down the values in a chart as number of cows x and number of days as y. When the number of cows are 16, then enough for 4 days. Now if number of cows are 32, then how many days the food will be sufficient? So this is inverse proportion, as the product of quantities should be constant. 16 multiplied by 4 is equal to 32 multiplied by x, and value of x we can calculate as 16 multiplied by 4 upon 32, and the answer is 2, which we will write here as 32 number of cows if is, then the food is enough for 2 days. Here we will take one more example. If 12 men can do a job in 30 days, how many men are needed to complete the job in 20 days? So the number of days to complete a work and the number of men for completing work are inversely proportional to each other. Here the product of them will be constant. So number of men into number of days is equal to constant. Let us consider this chart in which we have taken 20 days are required to complete the work by X men. So therefore 12 into 30 is equal to X into 20. For calculating value of X, we will transpose this 20. 12 into 30 is 360 divided by 20. So here we can say value of X on dividing we will get as 18. And finally we can say 18 men are required to complete the given job in 20 days. Dear friends, I hope you understood all the examples. Let us solve some examples as homework assignment from home. Here, 3 questions are given to you. Kindly complete them and note them in your notebook. We will meet in the next series with the next topic. Till then, goodbye. Thank you very much.